Welcome students. Today we are going to discuss how to approach the KMAT examination in English. That is, our topic is English. So you know, English will be having grammar part, comprehension and passage, vocabularies, synonyms, antonyms, error spotting, spelling, idioms and phrases, one word substitute, etc. These are all main topics of English which you will be getting for your examination. So we'll go one by one. We'll see how to approach each portion of the topic. Okay. The first one is comprehension passage. Comprehension means reading the passage and trying to understand the in-depth meaning of the passage and answering the questions that is given based on the passage. You can just like that read the passage, take your own time, but here we are going to go for competitive exam. So time is very important. We cannot waste our time. So everything is fast. So what you do is, this is the passage. So don't just read the passage. Go to the questions first. See, I told you don't read the passage. So now we have come to the questions. The employees in our country, see the options given, are quite punctual but not duty conscious. B, are not punctual but somehow manage to complete their work. C, are somewhat lazy but good natured. D, are not very highly qualified. So like that, what you do is you read this first question. Now you go to the passage. The first question was about the employees in our country. So look in this passage where it is written employees. I think in the second line it is there. It is a common sight in our country of employees reporting for duty on time and at the time, same time doing little work, etc. So some idea you are getting. So like that, what you do is you take the, seeing the first question, see whether you get, where you get that employees coming. Now you got it in the second line. Then look for the highlighted words. Here you can find highlighted word assessment. And one more highlighted word is bureaucrats. Okay. Now what you do is you read the full passage slowly. As you read the full passage, you'll get some idea. So this passage is about the employees in our country. So once you get the key idea what it is, then the remaining questions is going to be really easy for you. So you're given options in the first question. Based on that options, you can choose the right answer. Then like that, the employees in our country, we read that in the passage. Now let us see what are the options given. And are quite punctual but not duty conscious, that is option A. And option B, are not punctual but somehow manage to complete their work. And option C, are somewhat lazy but good natured. And D is, are not highly qualified. So what I feel is, the employees in our country, A will be the answer, are quite punctual but not duty conscious. So this is what had come in the passage. So this should be your answer. So always see that what is given in the passage, that should be the answer, not whatever you like, you are choosing. So like that, what you do is, the first one I have done for you. The same way, go to the second question. According to the writer, the administration in India with all the options. Then the word assessment means, see, I told you, look at the highlighted word. So now highlighted word assessment is given here. You have to find the meaning for that. The fourth question is the leadership in administration with so many options. The fifth one is the central idea of passage could be best expressed by the following. So by this time, you will be thorough with the passage and also the answers. So this is how you have to answer the comprehension questions. You don't take much time. I think maximum you can take is 5 minutes. By the time you are, and it's a very small passage, so you can finish it off. Like this, if you practice more passages, it will be easy for you. I'm leaving it to you. So you can find out the answers, and towards the end I'll be giving you the answer key. So with that you can verify whether your answer you chosen is right. If it is wrong, you should understand why it went wrong. The second topic is idioms and phrases. As you know, idioms and phrases play an important role in English, especially when you're talking. People just don't talk so many things. They just say in one word or in a phrase and then finish it off. So it is very important to know what are idioms and phrases. So you'll be getting in the question paper also topics based on idioms and phrases. So let us see how to answer the idioms and phrases. The second one is idioms and phrases. An idiom is a phrase or expression whose meaning cannot be understood from the ordinary meanings of the words in it. So, how good you are in English, that is why they give you these idioms and phrases. It is not like ordinary English. So, let us see what the first one is. To catch a tartar. What are the options given? To trap wanted criminal with great difficulty. To catch a dangerous person. To meet with disaster. To deal with a person who is more than once match. So from these options, you have to find your answer. To catch a tartar. So, to trap wanted criminal with great difficulty, to catch a dangerous person, to meet with disaster, to deal with a person who is more than once match. So, the answer will be B, to catch a dangerous person. So, like that, the next one, to drive home, it has got options. To have an axe to grind with options, to cry wolf with options, to end in smoke with options. See, it is not easy to understand, but we will be able to understand because our standard is very high. That is why these exams are given to you to estimate your standard. So you have to find the answers for these remaining idioms and phrases. The next question will be fillers. That is, a sentence is given, so that you have to see the exact meaning of the sentence given in the options. It's based on the tense or hidden meaning, etc. So let us see the question so it will be more easy for you to understand. The third question is an incomplete statement followed by fillers. So you have to pick the best one and complete the sentence. So let us see what the question is. That is the 11th one. Despite his best efforts to conceal his anger, and you are given fillers. So let us see what we have to fill it up with. A. We could detect that he was very happy. He failed to give us an impression of his agony. He succeeded in camouflaging his emotions. People came to know that he was annoyed. So you have to see what correct word sentence will fill this gap. So the answer will be D. Despite his best efforts to conceal his anger, people came to know that he was annoyed. So that is the answer. Then see the next question. That is the 12th one. His appearance is unsmiling, but the options are given. See the 13th question. If I come, it will not rain. I will not tell you the answer for this. You read it and you have to find out. The 14th is, she never visits any zoo because she is strong opponent of the idea of. So what comes here that you have to find out. Then the 15th is, I felt somewhat more relaxed. So this also you have to find out. So this is all given to you to find out what the answer is. The 4th question is one word substitute. One word substitute means you need not say much. Within one word you will finish off the answer. Like you have to meet a dermatologist. Actually, who is a dermatologist? Skin doctor. So instead of saying, I want to go meet a skin doctor, you can finish it in one word. I want to meet the dermatologist. I want to have an appointment with the surgeon. So that is called one word.
The head of your family is your father. You won't say head of the family. You'll say my father. It's understood. That is called one word substitute. A sentence is given and for that one word you have to say the answer. So let us see what is one word substitute.
So let us see what are the questions given. Taking the 16th question. List of the business or subjects to be considered at a meeting. See, the key word is meeting. So A is schedule, B is timetable, C is agenda, D is plan. So these are all coming under some kind of meeting, but it's a business meeting. So you have to think what it is. Business meeting means C is the answer, agenda. See the 17th one, leave or remove from a place considered dangerous. So the answer is interesting, but one thing you must notice, you have to speak well means you have to read well. If you read well, you will have more knowledge of English, that is vocabulary is very important. So the answer for that you have to find out, I am not going to tell. The 18th question is, a prima facie case is such. See the options and you have to find the answer. The 19th, a person pretending to be somebody he is not. So students, now we are going to the fifth topic, that is fill in the blanks. So that will have, the blanks will be either can be preposition, it can be adverb, can be any parts of the speech. So you have to read the options and you have to fill in with the correct word. So let us go to the topic and see what it is. Pick out the most effective words from the given words to fill in the blank to make the sentence meaningfully complete. So whatever word you are picking up should be an effective word. See the first one, fate smiles dash those who untiringly grapple with stark realities of life. A with, B over, C on, D round. So you have to fill in with the appropriate word. So C will be the answer. Fate smiles on is the answer. Like that, the miser gazed dash at the pile of gold coins in front of him. See the options, avidly, admiringly, thoughtfully, earnestly. You should know the meaning of the words and grammatically also how well it fits in. Only then you can fill it up with appropriate word. So like that, you have to fill these words. So it will have noun, it will be having prepositions, it will be having adverbs. So you should identify what will be the correct answer to be filled in. The sixth one is the direct speech, the indirect speech. So the word direct speech means directly the person is talking to you. So there is no change in it. But when you say indirectly, you are representing someone else and talking. So there will be a change. So a tense, there will be a change in the tense. Suppose if it was spoken in the present tense, when it is becoming indirect, can go to the past tense. So let us see with the topic, with the questions, how it goes.
In direct speech, the actual words with no change of speaker are quoted. The exact words are actually quoted. So let us see there, in inverted comma, if you don't keep quiet, I shall shoot you. So this is direct speech. Then indirect speech means the actual words of the speaker are changed. The reason for change in actual words is that the actual words have been spoken by the speaker in past. Hence, narrating it in the present will require change in the tense of the actual words. The 26th question, if you don't keep quiet, I shall shoot you. So this is a direct sentence. He said to her in a calm voice. So when you're going to choose the answer, that will be in indirect speech. So let us see what comes as the indirect speech for that. A, he warned her to shoot if she didn't keep quiet calmly. He said calmly that I shall shoot you
If you don't be quiet, see, he warned her calmly that he would shoot her if she didn't keep quiet. D. Calmly he warned her that be quiet or else he will have to shoot her. So C is the answer. He warned her calmly that he would shoot her if she didn't keep quiet.
See the 28th question. His father ordered him to go to his room and study. This is an indirect question. So there is no inverted comma. How will you differentiate? Direct speech will have inverted comma. Indirect will be just plain. So what can be the answer for this? His father said, see the answer is in direct speech. Go to your room and study in inverted comma. Second B, his father said to him, go and study in your room. C, his father shouted, go right now to your study room. D, his father said firmly, go and study in your room. So what can be the answer? A, his father said, go to your room and study. So this is the difference between direct and indirect. Yes, give the correct antonyms for the words in bold. Antonyms means opposite. So let us see what is the word. Frugal. A, copious. B, extravagant. C, generous. D, ostentatious. So here we have to give the opposite word. Like if I say beautiful, the opposite will be ugly. Like that, frugal. So means stingy. So what can be the opposite? Extravagant. So B is the answer, extravagant. Then 30th is impasse. So you have to find out what the word is. Then 31 is occasious. You have to find what the opposite word is. 32, famous. You have to find what the word is. Now we'll go to the synonyms. So, synonyms means similar meaning or same meaning. As you know, English is the one language which has got substitute words for one word. So, you can just throw those words to replace the existing word. So, the word is 33, shallow. So, what can be the answer for that? Shallow means A, artificial. B, superficial. C, foolish. D, worthless. So, shallow means little deep. So, what can be the meaning of that? Little deep means it's not very deep. So, it's on the top only. So, it's called superficial. B, superficial is the answer. Then is feeble, weak, vain, arrogant, sick, harbinger, with options, candid. Then we have destitution. The 9th question is error spotting. It's very important and many of the students find it very difficult also to do it. You should be very good in grammar, only then you can do this error spotting. But don't think that it's going to be that tough. If you have thorough knowledge and by practice, you'll be able to do this error spotting. So let us not waste time and see what the questions are. 9th one, error spotting. Error spotting, I told you, you have to find where the error is. So where the error is, that will be the answer. Like A, I could not put up in a hotel. B, because the boarding and lodging charges. C, were exorbitant. D, no error. Sometimes there will be no error only. That time you have to mark it as no error. So don't think that every time there will be some error in the question. It's not like that. It's very tricky. Sometimes they might give you error. Sometimes there won't be any error. That is left to you to understand and judge properly. So here, I could not put up in a hotel. You won't say in a hotel. In. So its answer will be, I could not put up at a hotel. At means it's a place. It's a proposition. So the answer is A. So the error is in A. So the answer is A. Like that, the remaining questions you have to do. Try to do it. You will get it. And only by practice makes a man perfect. So till 40, 41, 42. So these many questions in error spotting. Similarly, look at the 40th question, 41st and 42nd question and try to do it. Identify the correct or wrong spelling in the list given below. See, English language spelling is very important. When you're orally speaking, nobody is bothered. But when you're writing it down, spelling counts. So the mistake is a mistake, spelling mistake. That is why they give you spelling as a portion in the competitive exam. So either you have to find the correct spelling or you have to find the wrong spelling. So that is the answer. The first one you see, spot the correct spelling. A is given committee, B is also committee, C is committee, D is committee. So what can be the right answer? You have to identify. When they give the same spelling, it's a bit confusing. So they will be reducing the E or adding one E or I, etc. So here the answer is C, committee. The next one, find the misspelt word. That means what? One will be misspelt, the remaining will be correct. So you annex, anniversary, animate, animosity. So anniversary is a wrongly spelt word. A-N-N-I-V-E-R-S-A-R-Y is the correct spelling. So they want to know which is wrongly spelled. So B, anniversary is the answer. Similarly, the 45th question, choose the word with wrong spelling. You have to choose it. Then coming to the 46th, find the correctly spelt word. You have to find the correctly spelt one. That is the answer. The 47th question, find out the correct spelling. Shakespeare, a great writer. So you have to know which is having the correct spelling. That will be the answer. And the 48th, choose the word wrongly spelt. So anything they can ask. Sometimes they will ask you only what is the correctly spelled. Sometimes they will ask you what is the wrongly spelled. Sometimes they will mix and ask you. So read the question properly and then you have to answer. The last question in this question paper, that is para jumbles. So students, the last question para jumbles, or you can call it jumbled. By mistake I told you closest. Closest doesn't come in this. Okay. So only para jumbles and jumble. So it's not in order, or you can say ordering of sentences, ordering of words, etc. Here there is no order in it. What is your duty? See, if I say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it is in order. It's a sequence. If I say 4, 1, 3, 5, it's not in order. So put it in order means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you are, and it should have a logical order. There should be a meaning to what is given. Then here it is mixed and given. So when you put it in order, the passage will have its meaning. So that is to see how well you understand the passage, how well you can put it in order, whether you are taking it properly, understanding properly, or you are confusing with what is given. To identify that, this kind of exams are given. Okay, para jumbles. The first one you see. S1. S1 means the starting of the sentence. So that will be permanent. That will stay as it is. Venice is a strange and beautiful city in the north of Italy. So that is the starting sentence given. So see the remaining between. P, Q, R, S. P, Q, R, S is the word. These are the sentences. They are confused, mixed. So this is the one which you have to arrange in order. And see S6. That is also constant. This is because Venice has no streets. So when you are arranging the PQRS, whatever sentence comes below S1 should go with S1. And when you are finishing it, the last sentence of your arrangement should go with S6. So let us see how what it is. P, there are about 400 old stone bridges joining the island of Venice. Q, in this city, there are no motor cars, no horses, no buses. R, these small islands are near one another. Yes, it is not an island, but 117 islands. And they given you the proper sequence should be A, B, C, D. The sequence is given. Your duty is to identify the correct sequence. So what you do is, you first go to the
sequence. What you do, you take A, you apply PQRS, you apply PQRS and C. P, there are about 400 and old. PQRS is already there, the same thing, so it's not in order. Then PRQS, there are about 400 old stone bridges joining the island of Venice. R, these small islands are near one another. Again, you find there is no order in it. Then let us see C, SRPQ. Venice is a strange and beautiful city north of Italy. S is what? It is not an island, but 117 islands. So they are speaking about Italy. So S goes with S1. After S1, S comes. It is not an island, but 117 islands. Then let us see what is R. These small islands are near one another. That is, it's connecting again. We are talking about islands. Again, this R is talking about islands. So connecting with S. Then CP. There are about 400 old stone bridges joining the island of Venice. Again, there is a connection between that. Then the next one is Q, the last one. In this city, there are no motor cars, no horses, no buses. What is the final sentence? This is because Venice has no streets. So the correct answer is C, SRPQ. That is how you identify the jumble. Sometimes they'll give two or four or five questions, the same pattern. So it's easy for you to do. So practice this more. The one more question what I have given, that you have to do it on your own. The 50th question. I read an advertisement that said. So the options are given. PQRS. Then the proper sequence should be. You have to identify which comes as the proper sequence. Like this questions also you do more. This will really help you. And where you can score easily marks. These areas you can score easily marks. And you can do it also. The students, we have gone through many topics of what's going to come for your exam. I explained to you in the short time whatever I can. So your duty is to do the remaining questions. I'll be giving you the answer key and then you have to verify with the answer key. You prepare well. Each questions, each subject, each topic you have to prepare well. Only then you can answer these. First you prepare, you know the pattern. So some topics you take and you prepare and then you go for answering the questions. That will help you. That will boost your confidence also. So don't worry. I am very sure you will be able to do well and come out successfully. So for today's class, I am winding it. Thank you.